I would like to share two types of smiles and demonstrate how they look and what happens when we smile differently. Now, the first smile will be a fake smile. And I would like you to notice the difference between that and the second smile, which is a genuine smile. So let's go. The first smile is this. And as you can see, there's something that, although looks like a smile, the lips are there, but something is missing. Now, the fake smiles are generally run by a muscle that's called zygomaticus muscle that lifts the tip of the lips and stops pretty much there. Whereas the genuine smile looks like this. Now, what happens in a genuine smile is the not just zygomaticus muscles, but also orbicularis oculi. The muscles that surround the eyes get activated and they lift the cheeks up and they make sort of the crow's feet around the eyes. You know, that's why we see when people smile and we see the eyes smiling together with the mouth, that is a genuine smile. Now, why is that important? The research that tells us there is a huge difference in the way how we smile. If we smile predominantly with our fake smiles throughout the day, we actually increase the likelihood of having issues with our health. Now, we don't want that. We want to experience and smile genuinely and surround ourselves with experience and people that make us smile genuinely. Because a genuine smile brings healthy benefits. And it is much better than chocolate or even sex in the activation of pleasure hormones. Smile is a powerhouse in terms of endorphins and feeling good hormones. Have you noticed when you are surrounded by people who smile, you feel better and you start smiling as well? Now, why does that happen? We all have mirror neurons. So when we see someone smiling, we mimic that unconsciously with our own muscles. So those zygomaticus muscles start activating and orbicularis oculi start working. And then when we interpret it as a genuine smile, we feel much better because our brain gets a signal of something joyful, something happy happening with us. So this is a really good way to experience joy in life. Just surround ourselves with good and smiley and happy people. There's a body of research that supports the idea that smiling prolongs the span of life. Well, definitely when we feel better, I guess we just want to live longer, right? So there's a research done on basketball team, the cards of basketball team players in 1952, where they analyzed team players with the largest and biggest kind of smiles. And then they looked at their lifespan and observed that people who, those basketball players who had a wide and genuine smile, they lived on average 6 to 7 years longer. As a relationship psychologist, I also noticed people who smile more, they bounce back from stress much quicker. They get this resilience, that emotional intelligence, that ability to combat stress and be there, be resilient to what's happening around them because they have their inner smile. They take their good weather with them. We know that smiling makes people be more attractive, to be more likable, to be more memorable, to look more competent. We know that smiling builds the relationship and connection between two people. In one of the UK studies, they found that smiling stimulates the same brain stimulus mechanisms for rewards, similar to chocolate, sex, and receiving financial remuneration. And moreover, a smile would be as strong as eating 2,000 chocolate bars or having £16,000 in cash received. So that's the power of a smile. If you like this video, subscribe to this channel where I can share more practical tools to help you enrich your life.